out to wish us good luck on the show, and actually George Takei might like this. The governor of California, who calls in regularly to this show, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Governor, hello.
Good morning, Howard. How are you?
First of all, I called your office and asked you to call in because we read about your motorcycle accident and your lip was injured. I think you took 12 stitches. Is that correct?
It's 15 stitches. Yes, I'm sitting here recuperating. It's a real pain in the ass. I cannot believe what happened. But listen, first of all, I want to congratulate you on your move to Sirius. This is fantastic. Good for you.
Yeah, we're enjoying it here, and things are really, you know, as they should be. We're feeling a creative renaissance, Mr. Governor.
Yes. Yeah, I can tell you guys are talking about monkey vaginas, and you're saying the F word. It's fantastic.
Yeah, we're really taking this new freedom and doing wonderful things with it.
Yes, you're really pushing the bar and doing great things for it. I love it.
I'm sure the guy who invented satellite envisioned us. You know what I read? I read some article on the guy who kind of figured some Israeli guy or something put these satellites up because he thought it could bring world peace. Like, in other words, we could broadcast into the Congo where people don't get information and poverty and disease.
How are they going to get a unit?
And I don't know, but he had this whole vision. But basically, what we're doing is
inciting riots.
Like talk about monkey vagina. It's great.
That's funny.
Yeah. Well, anyway, so tell me about you were driving your motorcycle.
He had his son in the sidecar.
Yeah. Why are you driving around in motorcycles? You're the governor. I mean, don't you want to?
Well, listen, they were having a good time out there. My son and I like to go driving and the bike. And this woman pulled out and ended up smacking into her car. And, you know, this woman, unfortunately, was one of these Mexicans. It was a Mexican woman, and you know,
was she an illegal? You don't know if she was legal or not.
Of course, they're all illegal, Howard. You know this. And now they all jumped the wall. I tell you something. They're always so distracted when they're driving. They're too busy eating burritos or making babies. I don't know what they're doing.
Right.
While they drive.
So tired of it.
So the woman got distracted, and do you feel that she didn't understand English? Is this what you're claiming? You don't know.
No, I got all the cars that you speak English, you know, you son of a bitch, what the hell's the matter with
you? So you're angry about this?
Absolutely. I mean, my face is a mess. My lip is so huge that Maria will not even kiss me. And I said, Maria, you know, what's the big deal? Between my giant lip and your giant cheeks, you've got something here, you know.
Well, you've always had such a great sense of humor. By the way, the great George Takei is our announcer. I don't know if you've heard about this. George, this could be an opportunity. George, you're angry with the governor, aren't you?
Well, I'm very disappointed with you, Governor Schwarzenegger. You know, because when you ran for office, you made all these moderate statements on various issues, one of them being the fact that you have worked with gays and lesbians in the motion picture business, that you feel very comfortable, and that you have no problem with it. But when the real moment of truth came for you, when the California legislature did a landmark thing, passed the same-sex marriage bill, and all that was required for that to become the law of the state was your signature, just one signature. And you chose to go against all those things that you said during the campaign, and you played to the most reactionary, conservative, narrow segment of your base. And you vetoed that bill. I was aghast. I mean, here you had the chance to prove yourself. And, you know, you've been doing that same sort of flip-flop on so many things. When the ballot measures that you supported.
Well, let's let the governor respond.
All right, yes.
My God. You must be one of those gays, George, right? Are you one of the gays?
I am gay, yes.
You're one of the gays, right? You like to take it in the backside?
I don't think we need to get into that.
I don't think George is making a joke of this, Mr. Governor. I mean, really, he really would like a response.
Let me say something.
Go ahead.
Listen, I believe, of course, that gay marriage should be between a man and a woman. I've always said that. And
you're saying gay
marriage? Let me. You say that gay marriage should be between. I mean, you say marriage should be between a man and a woman.
Right.
What are the fundamental pillars of a marriage? It is a commitment to each other.
Right.
To take responsibility for each other.
Well, Governor,
and the vagina. The penis and the vagina.
That's it?
That's it.
You know what? So many so-called marriages between a man and a woman are the most abusive sort of relationships.
Well, George, let's find out the answer to your question. You said one thing when you ran, and then you George is upset because all you needed was one signature. Now, what about that?
You flip-flopped.
Right. Well, unfortunately, that day, I did not have a pen that was working, so it was a very difficult situation. I said, listen, guys, can I get a pen? Oh, shit, so I couldn't do it. So,
Governor, you have a serious responsibility, and you're treating it so flippantly. Is this the way you're going to conduct your governorship?
Yeah, I mean, Governor,
listen,
why not?
You've got to have fun. Everybody's too goddamn serious about everything.
Were you having fun with the same-sex marriage bill? Were you having fun with the fact that despite you are a Republican and you play to the conservative elements of the Republican Party, you took on as your chief of staff a liberal lesbian Democrat?
Answer the questions, Governor. Do you think George is being annoying here?
He's pissing me off because, I've just been in an accident. I've got 15 stitches. I'm sitting here in bed.
I feel very sorry for you. I feel your pain. But I'm talking about an issue that's important.
Answer the thing about the gay stuff here. Come on.
I love gays, all right? I love gays.
That's what you said during the campaign.
Let me tell you something. I went and saw the movie Brokeback Mountain recently.
Yeah, speak about that.
Yes, and I walked out of the movie theater with Maria, and they said, Maria, what a touching movie about two men who are in love and cowboys. And I love seeing those guys naked. They're so cute, those guys. Jake Gyllenhaal, I said, Maria, hold me.
So you were not uptight about seeing the movie Brokeback Mountain?
Absolutely not. I'd see it again. I love it. Fantastic.
Right. And don't you think
The governor went to see Brokeback Mountain. He's trying to form a bond here, I think, with you.
You know what? I hear the echoes of the campaign again.
He should be rethinking his position on gay marriage if he loved
Absolutely.
That movie.
Will you rethink your position? Now that you love Brokeback Mountain and you went, will you rethink your position?
Absolutely. Because of this movie, because I saw these two actors getting it on in a tent or whatever it is and all that stuff, they're very cute. And I said, maybe the gays aren't bad. I like the gays. Right. Maybe I support them. And also, George is one of them Asians, and they can't drive for shit out of here either.
You're joking.
We can't trust you because you are very frivolous, flip about this. And how can we trust you with a position of responsibility
that affects
so many people's lives?
George, the governor's always called in and gotten into the spirit of the show, which I appreciate. But I know you're bringing up a very serious issue. And Governor... you've said to me privately that a lot of the gays just whine about their own issues. Is that how you really feel?
Yeah, they're always whining. If you want the same rights as regular, the heterosexual people, fine. You can get divorces like they do. You can go through all the shit that they go through because it's a pain in the ass. If you want me to, listen, for you, George, because I like you. I think you're a great actor. I enjoy your stuff. I would totally sign off on the bill and let the gays do whatever they want. But I got to say something. We're going to pass a bill out here that will not allow Mexican women or Asians to drive cars anymore because I can't stand this shit.
Wait a minute. Did I hear you right? Did I hear you say that sign the bill if it's passed again?
Now, that's big news.
Why not?
George,
did say you will sign it.
Why not? Sure.
We got that commitment from you.
And
you're not being flip and frivolous.
Look, George, I'm pumped up with so much Vicodin right now. I would.
You're taking it back.
You're
on Vicodin because of your accident?
Absolutely. I don't even know what I'm saying right now.
So we can't trust what you're saying.
Well, it's not my fault, George. I mean, at this point, I'd take a massage from you.
I'd like to see that.
Why don't you come down here? That would be great.
I will give you that massage if you sign that bill.
Yeah.
All right, that's it. It's a done deal. If you give me a back rub plus a little reach around, I will sign the bill.
You've got a deal.
Now, Mr. Governor, in all seriousness.
Now, we're breaking all kinds of news here.
You are not.
Actually, I think I'd enjoy that.
George, may I be honest? I know you're in a committed relationship, but are you attracted to someone like Arnold Schwarzenegger who takes care of his body? Aside from your political difference here, physically, is he your type?
Well, I like the discipline. His body is too muscular for me, but I like his discipline that it results in that kind of musculature. I love the kind of fact that, he takes care of himself. Too many Americans don't. And so I do respect you for that, and I do respect you for all your achievements as an actor and as a businessman and the fact that you were able to convince enough people to vote for you.